Let's talk about Semantic Cache and do a brief code walkthrough. A cache is a high-speed memory that efficiently stores frequently accessed data. Semantic Cache is a specific type of cache that has gained popularity in RAG-based applications. In a vanilla RAG, when a user asks a question, we embed the question and then search our vector database. We can perform a keyword, semantic, or hybrid search to find the relevant documents. We can then retrieve the matched context and pass it along with the prompt and user question to the LLM. The LLM generates a response, which is sent back to the user. This is the workflow of a RAG. If the user asks the same question repeatedly, the entire process from A to Z will occur each time. So, to avoid generating the same response multiple times for a frequently asked question, we can store these questions and their corresponding answers in a cache. This way, when a user asks a question, we can retrieve the response from the cache if it already exists. We need to add a cache component to the system to implement this. For example, if a user asks, "What is the capital of Brazil?" for the first time, we generate a response and save it in the cache. The next time the same question is asked, we can retrieve the answer from the cache. This type of cache is quite common, and we can store the question as the key and its answer, Brasilia, as the value. We need a mechanism to search through the cache and see if the key, which is the question, exists. So, if the key exists, we can retrieve the answer from the cache instead of generating a new response. When using a key-value cache, it's important to keep in mind that slight variations in the wording of a question can result in a different hash value being generated for it. For example, "What is the capital of Brazil?" and "Can you tell me the capital of Brazil?" are essentially the same questions, but the verbatim phrasing is different. If we use a naive approach to search for the answer in the cache, we may not be able to find it because the hashed version of the question is different. This is because the cache mechanism hashes the input to generate a key. Because the strings are different, their hash values will also be different. Therefore, it's crucial to implement a more sophisticated approach that considers variations in phrasing to ensure that the cache can provide accurate answers to user queries. To improve the accuracy of the search results, we can use a semantic cache instead of relying on an exact match mechanism. This would involve storing the questions and answers and their embeddings in a key-value mechanism. So, when a user asks a question, we can perform a semantic search on all the questions in the cache to find the most similar one to the user's question. Suppose the similarity score between the user's question and the most similar question in the cache is above a certain threshold. In that case, we can assume that the user's question is essentially the same as the matched question and provide the corresponding answer to the user. But in production environments, a tip is to avoid using a threshold to determine the similarity between questions, as it may not be reliable. Instead, try using a less expensive LLM to check if the questions are the same. Okay, let's continue. If you are using LLM on question answer system, such as OpenAI, for example, and you have to do a lot of OpenAI calls, this will cost a lot of money. This is where a semantic cache solution shines, because it will be extremely efficient and fast. Okay, when generating text for an application, using cache may not be a good idea if you want different variations for multiple queries. However, using a cache in a question answering system is good, as the variation doesn't matter. Also, using a cache is a great way to optimize the performance of chatbots by storing frequently accessed data. One interesting way to utilize the cache is by creating ad hoc patches for chatbot dialogues. This approach involves identifying commonly asked questions and preparing pre-written responses in advance. The chatbot can quickly retrieve the prepared responses from the cache and instantly respond to the user's query without touching an LLM. Let's take a look at the code together. So here, we are creating a semantic cache in a RAG system. We will focus just on semantic search and caching, not a complete RAG implementation with prompt and LLM. This way, we can concentrate only on cache behavior. For vector database and semantic cache, you will only need Qdrant. First, you must install some libraries, Qdrant client, and other necessary items. After that, you can set up your vector database in this section. So here we are creating with Qdrant Cloud a collection, which is the vector database, to store essentially all the chunks of text, embeddings, and everything else. Then I populate the vector database with the documents and their metadata. In this case, I'm using a PubMed dataset with questions and answers available on Hugging Face. By the way, links in the description. So, I'm using Qdrant to create the semantic cache system. This simplifies things, and I don't need to use another options. I have the vector store with data in the cloud, and here I have Qdrant with in-memory persistence. And yes, we could even store the cache permanently on disk. Usually, you cache it like an in-memory cache. So, when the user asks a question, we have to embed the question. The embedding has to be done regardless of whether you are using a cache, because even to search the cache, it is necessary to embed the user's query. Now it is going and searching through the cache to see if this question has already been answered. Search through all of the embeddings and compare them with the embedding of the question. If it is in the cache, then we can return the response from the cache. And what you have to do, you need to set a threshold. If the threshold is above that, the similarity is high enough. So again, this depends on the metric that you are using here. In this case, an Euclidean distance is being used, so Euclidean distance is the actual absolute distance. So in this case, if the similarity score is very low, the lower, the better, meaning that they are very close to each other. If it is a cosine similarity, you want bigger numbers, because bigger means they are more similar. And this is the most important part, so this code here will search the cache. If it exists, it will only return the answer to the question that actually exists in the cache. Otherwise, it will just go through the normal RAG process, where you simply go to the vector database, in this case Qdrant in the cloud, find the top k similarity chunks, and then pass that with the user query and the prompt for the LLM, and then just generate a new response and send the new one to the cache. So, I hope you like it. The links are in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.